Hey everyone, welcome back to CryptoCash. Thank you so much again for joining me here. Hope you're having a great day. Let's take another look here at SUI, see what's going on. We've got our bullish rectangle breakout slash retest of that previous resistance range at about 328. So good news is the price didn't break down to this 310 range. It continued higher and has since held above this previous resistance turned support. So the likelihood of further upside is greater because of that, but we also got to be careful not to take a long into a Bitcoin correction. But if you do look at the way that Bitcoin is behaving and SUI is working, it's holding fairly strong, and I think there's a solid chance that Bitcoin maintains this 89 to 90k range. SUI is going to take off, probably hit its 1.272 fib around 390. We do need to update our fib levels. That's based on yesterday's candlestick closure, so please keep that in mind. But either way you look at it here, looking pretty solid is a good start here. So let's take a quick peek at the backend data for SUI, see what's going on with liquidation, and go from there. Usually when we look at liquidation levels, we want to kind of understand how many people are shorting and longing in the market. The delta is something we'll look at next, but for the moment, we can see a tremendous amount of people are shorting $3.55 to $4. Why people short this coin, I don't know. It doesn't make a ton of sense. However, I do understand the concept of, you know, Bitcoin establishing lower lows, lower highs. You know, SUI should pull back, but it really doesn't, and rarely does. Obviously, it has a propensity to do so, but the likelihood of that is lower, especially if we kind of zoom out here and look at this is the last, 30 days? We can see a tremendous amount. We got about maybe about 2 to 3 billion in liquidation, upwards about 380. So I think we usually, it's in your best interest to usually follow the liquidation levels, honestly, especially when you're in price discovery. Nothing else works as a better guide than that. So either way you look at it here, we look at the liquidation delta, we can see it is steadily increasing, showing there's more support in this range and more people taking longs. So that's a good sign. If this number stays too high for too long, we could see the price action pull back. But again, it depends on how you look at it here. Because if we look at our open interest, basically our local point of control, in the last 7 days of price action, you know, 307, 315, those are two areas of heavy concentration where people are pretty significantly invested. So it reaffirms that support for us, and that's a really good sign. And as you can see here, with Bitcoin recovering, SUI is recovering very well. In fact, you could say that it's due to break out here shortly. So let's talk about the daily time frame, see what's going on. And to clarify, this is pretty much the bumper sticker version for every daily time frame right now. It's truly bullish. There's no other way around it. There's nothing here kind of telling us that we have a shift in momentum. While stochastic's kind of sort of pulling back a little, that's a very premature indicator to use. We're still well over 70 in the RSI. So basically just implying if you have a long position open, just keep it open. Really, that's all there is to it. Again, this is more so from a long-term holder perspective, but on the same accord, when it comes to the money flow index, it's super high. There's a lot of reasons why SUI is not going anywhere. We can see the same thing here. We're honoring the 20-day SMA, staying above it. We didn't break below it, so we're good shape there. Even if we did break below, we do have that support about 310. We could very well see a pivot if the price does pull back. In fact, that's an area of interest for me at 310. If, you know, just say Bitcoin, for example, corrects itself to 86, 87K, we'd probably see, you know, 285 to 310 as a potential reality for SUI. If so, those are two solid considerations for longs. We got this nice 0.618 fib level. In fact, let's go ahead and adjust our fib levels here for the moment, just to kind of get perspective on what that looks like. Again, that 0.618 fib levels and that 0.65, that golden pocket is lining up perfectly with this 290 mark. Okay, so 290/310 or 315 is that area of control. So good news is price pulls back, we got a lot of support there. We're also comfortably here with the RSI is pulling back and the money flow kind of increasing. That's a very, very good sign in this area, right? And it does imply a breakout to the upside is very likely, okay? Now, I'm still leaning a little bit more towards Bitcoin pulling back a bit further, still establishing lower lows and lower highs. It's definitely looking like it wants to break down. And if that is the case, I do feel like we might see a slight correction from SUI first. So just know, 290 to 315 is that range in which adding to your position might be a beneficial circumstance there. But either way you look at it here, pretty much every single thing on the 4-hour time frame is looking pretty solid. I do like that the RSI is maintaining above 50 and under 70. It's actually a good sign. When indicators cool down like that, that's more of a bullish convergence or a type of hidden bullish convergence. I really hate that term, but the concept here remains true that with the RSI is coming down, cooling off, and the price going up, That's generally a good sign, especially when you're going to be retesting an all-time high here recently. So just keep that in mind. Take a look at the Ichimoku cloud. We're above the cloud. Lagging span is kind of sort of free and clear. This is a little bit on the choppy side. Conversion lines below the baseline too. So I really don't love the hourly time frame here. This doesn't give me a lot of confidence to want to take a long. If I were to take a long, I'd probably wait for the price to pull back. That's just my general, that's how I operate when it comes to trading in anyways. So you'll always hear that from me. But the truth is a ton of support just below the price action, the local point of control at 320. Kind of reaffirms that if the price pulls back at all, it would be a solid consideration. You're more likely to find benefit going up than down with this coin. Okay, so that's kind of what we're looking at there. So mostly awesome stuff. While this is not a perfect situation, it's mostly optimal, and the likelihood of further upside makes a lot more sense. Just be mindful that Bitcoin could correct itself here soon, and you know that does factor in here. So just trade carefully if you do. All right, so be sure to check us out on Twitter, Telegram, and Discord. I'm going to post a playout chart here shortly. They look a little something like this, and just kind of giving you a perspective on what I think is going to happen next with XYZ coin. And also make sure you join us over at BitUnix, progressive price pool 60K. We're soon to unlock that here in just a little bit more volume. So congrats to anyone who is getting that nice little extra bonus there from BitUnix. Phenomenal exchange, folks. No KYC or VPN, check them out. All right, I hope you all have a good rest of your day. We'll see you in the next one. Take care.